Hello, everybody. Welcome to Video Games Awesome Live. This is the Stanley Parable. It's awesome. Started out as a Half-Life mod and then got immense popularity. I know almost nothing about this, and that's probably the best thing that could happen for our audience, I think. Going into this, I purposefully kept myself in the dark, and it's one of these games that polarizes, I think. But I have a feeling, based on the trailers and what I've heard from the creator and his narrator in various media, that I'm going to like that. You might remember the trailer. that used black and white footage of how a video game is made. So it should be fun. But first, we're going to play the demo, because the demo is apparently its own story. It's not even just a snippet of the game. It's a completely separate experience.
Sweet.
So we're just going to jump into that. I wanted this one up because it has a nice office walla. Yeah. I think that we got it right by dressing this way. I had a feeling, just based on the imagery I've seen, that it's like kind of like a, it's about like being in an office hell.
You know what? This just the audio itself depresses me and makes me think about working in an office.
Is this like one of your dreams where you wake up and you're like, oh, I thought I was late for work and I hadn't been there in like weeks?
Yes, totally. Or like I'm sitting there and I'm trying to figure out how to quit my job, but I'm too scared to. I don't think you clicked demo there, eh?
Becky was really traumatized by her time.
It was fun. This was actually one of my favorite suits to wear there. Hmm. Oh, it has pockets.
Oh.
So get hype out there, you get hype geometry nerds. The Stanley Parable.
Oh.
I had meant to make that joke earlier.
Good thing you caught it.
I was gonna start it with that, but
it's funnier this way.
No, it's not.
We'll say this.
I don't know what...
What's going on?
Yeah, I don't know. That happens every so often at the beginning of playing it. All right, here we go. Beginning the demo.
Fraser reminds me of Dilbert.
You remind me of Dilbert.
I do?
Not them.
Oh.
Because it's all text and he was a comic.
Whoa.
The Stanley Trapezoid.
Shut up, chat.
Do you like my calculator?
Nice one.
I actually borrowed it from work.
You stole that?
No, I borrowed it. It's massive.
The Stanley Parable demonstration. I was actually, it wasn't even a title screen.
No, read it.
I don't.
It said boobies.
Good for you, Becky.
Go that way.
So, I had planned to actually play the original Half-Life mod today, but then I was told at the last minute that the game is like more like a remake. I thought it was like a sequel, but apparently it kind of repeats a lot of what was in the demo, or the mod, so.
Oh, okay.
The best part about this game being released on Steam, is that the creator's actually going to finally make some fucking money off of his runaway success.
Nice.
And then he'll have super notch powers soon. Get himself a fedora.
Super notch.
It's just a fedora.
By Microsoft. The Stanley Parable demonstration this way. God damn it.
Is that our number?
Welcome to the Stanley Parable demonstration. Your number is 28. When your number is displayed, please enter the demonstration room. Thank you, and have a pleasant demonstration.
She had a little sultriness to her voice. Oh, I want to see what this is. Can I jump?
Sounds like you're clicking a keyboard.
Not yet, I don't think.
I want to see what's on that sheet. This is how I play games. I do everything but play the game. Fine.
Hurry, or you'll miss your number.
Yeah, really.
Hey, it looks like a plane transfer at the Montreal airport.
Ooh. Yeah. Oh, God.
Waiting room. Please wait for your number and then enter. Thank you.
Dude, that wasn't your number.
Shit. No, I think it means in there.
No, serving 21.
Oh, this is going fast.
I don't understand how this works. Where's 22?
Maybe in the other room.
Where's 23
maybe
now?
There's more than one entrance.
Yeah, that was receptionist still one.
Eh, I'm here to play a game, not wait. Hey, that's a gunpoint.
Oh, fun!
Oh.
Hmm.
Oh. Oh, I don't know what that is. Is that a...
I don't know what that is.
I'm not sure what that one is. Famous demos. I didn't read that.
Awesome.
Nice.
a what? Oh, I came on the day off.
Oh, hello, hello, hello. Oh. Welcome to the Stanley Parable live demonstration.
Hello, Stephen Fry.
It will be my pleasure to guide you through this sneak peek at what to expect in the Stanley Parable. A tease, just enough to leave you hungry for more. How exciting. Can't you just feel that nervous tension? The looming uncertainty? Why don't we drink in the anticipation for a moment, just for 20 minutes or so? Please, for just 20 minutes, don't move or act in any way. Simply remain motionless and let the thrill of demoing the Stanley Parable wash over you.
Who has tested that?
Yeah.
I'm testing it right now.
Guys, I know it's not Stephen Fry. It's a joke about how every English narrator is Stephen Fry. Jesus Christ.
Oh, wait, I've got it. You know what would really ramp up the anticipation? If I gave you a little tour of the facility and show you how we make video game demonstrations. Yes, you'll be simply out of your mind with anxiety. Come
hey.
Along this way.
I have more patience than the narrator.
Yeah.
This is where I and the other proctors have been working meticulously to construct a demo that explains clearly and concisely exactly what the Stanley Parable is, how it plays, and why you should spend real-world money on the main game. Video game demonstrations are tricky, and without the proper technology, you run the risk of the player having no idea what to expect in the full version.
So he's going to show us all about what's going to happen in the main game then. Give me a nice slice of it so I'll make my decision whether to buy it or not. Maybe you should throw some of your best baddies at me.
Ah, here is one such technology. These buttons are meant to convey the meaning of choice and the impact of the decisions you make. After all, choices carry tremendous meaning and consequence. Didn't you know that?
Go ahead.
Why don't you try picking one of these buttons to press, and we'll see what your choice says about you.
I know what one I'd pick.
Which one?
Three over and three up.
Motherfucker. That's not the Stanley Parable's fault. I'm not sure what's causing that. Let me... What is making it minimize? I have something going that's like... I think it's Pigeon. I think every time somebody in my mod chat talks, it brings that down. All right.
That's the one. What's it gonna do?
How fascinating. Did you know that 94% of all people who select that particular button are sexual predators? You see, our choices really do illuminate the very intangible nature of our minds and souls. Pervert.
Pervert. Damn it!
Wasn't my choice.
It was mine.
Becky's just a pedophile.
A pedo.
We saw Stephen Fry on Conan the other night.
Oh, really?
Stephen Merchant.
Fuck me.
I was like, what?
See, everybody's... Yeah. Anyways, Stephen Merchant with Conan, and they danced around. They stood up and danced, because they're very tall. Like, doing an impression of themselves at a club.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, see, when we're at clubs, we're so tall that everybody's down here, so I feel like a pedophile. And then Conan's like, oh, don't get me involved in this! And he walks away.
And Stephen Merchant's eyes are like...
Stephen Merchant's eyes are so pedophile.
Okay, what else can I show you then? This place is the buffalo of game design. Nothing is wasted.
The buffalo, okay. Wall technology.
Ooh, look at that.
Final choice. Emotion booths. the compliments and the demo status. Demo in progress.
This device tells you whether or not you're inside a video game demonstration. Somewhere around here, there's also a device that tells you whether or not you're inside a device that tells you whether or not you're inside a video game demonstration.
It's got a real Hitchhiker's Guide feel to it. I need compliments.
One of the most important parts of administering any demonstration is pumping up your ego and appealing to insecurities about your sense of self-worth. That's why we use this room to develop cheap compliments to shower on the player during the demo.
Cool.
Go ahead and press that button to see some of the superficial flattery we've been cooking up. My heavens, I've never met someone who can consume as much uranium in a single sitting as you can. Just look at you go.
Thank you.
Of all the people I know who are playing this exact demo at this exact moment and standing in this exact room, your performance is easily in the top 5,000. Top 4,700 even.
Oh,
I won't go as far as 4,600.
Okay. That's fair.
Let's see. Oh, this is embarrassing. I really can't think of anything else to say. No. You've really exhausted my list of compliments. Goodness, that was fast. Either you or this department has a lot of room for improvement. Okay then, what's next?
Room for improvement. Story of my life.
Is there an improvement room? Because if there is, you should go to that.
This might be it. The isolation chamber, that's where I usually improve myself. And that's where Deacon goes to cry.
Aww.
He should at least think about improving himself, but he doesn't. Emotion booths.
Now here's what we use to convey story. These booths convert text from a story into raw emotion. Go ahead, step into one of them and feel the sheer power of narrative exposition.
Speaking of Deacon, let's see what it's like to live in his shoes for a moment.
Where did these cliffs go? These crags that we stood upon, they shielded us from our own ignorance, spoke coddling words and wrapped our vulnerabilities in a woolen cloth that so many times I tried to set aflame. If I knew these comforts now,
is this King Lear?
Would their fibers be any more sensitive to the heat of my touch? Perhaps it was the cold I desired most of all. That empress to whom my flesh was always invisible. A hammock for the bones, waiting to be touched and to be known.
Look up? Oh shit. I didn't look up. Oh, so that's how David Cage does it.
Go in that one now.
Yeah.
It was though and within the shame he carried that ocean breeze did drift. The fierceness of the tides, the inevitable collapse of their kingdoms, washed ashore, bereft of shame, martyrs devoid of a cause, ripping and tearing at the eternal
almost
seams.
A bear?
A vessel without a captain, carrying itself like plastic in the wind, hinting at a purpose that was truer in some distant memory, if only it could decipher through time's veneer whose memory it wanted to be.
Why is there a fly in here?
I don't
fuck
know.
Off fly.
He's been hanging out for a while.
Ah, son of a
all buzzing around
fucking
and shit.
Asshole.
He's a big guy, too.
Jesus Christ. All right. Well, he's welcome here. You know, it seems suitable to have a depressing single fly.
Now, we have to save at least a few emotions for the full game.
I want to see them all.
We're feeling half of these. Embarrassment, confusion, definitely confusion. Courage, not so much.
Yeah, no.
Happiness?
Talk to me later.
You went in both booths? Oh, how vulnerable of you. If at any point during the demo you need to cry, just let me know and we can take a minute.
There's one more booth, by the way. It's a secret booth.
Important rules for properly administering demonstrations. Get right to gameplay. Give a brief summary of the game's plot rather than a full explanation. Hint at the first boss, but don't give away exactly who it is just yet. Make all cutscenes skippable. Demo should be exactly 8 minutes. Players should not be confused.
It's a good list.
Where's the secret booth?
In the back.
Beer.
Back in
the booth.
Oh.
Oh.
I don't know how to duck, though.
Crawl between the black ones.
No, it's LB. Ooh, it's a special...
Oh.
Secret.
Oh, shit.
It's okay.
What? Gives me a craving for Daft Punk.
That was worth it.
Thanks for the tip. Please wait for you. Oh, it's just sitting there. What, you guys wanted a fresh dance? No. No. I don't dance to real songs.
This is serious stuff.
Yeah, I dance to intense. Only legal drama do I ever dance to, really, when it comes down to it.
Every time I come in and you're watching Law and Order.
Or the Pelican's Briefs.
Ooh.
Ah, now this room is perhaps the most important you'll encounter in the demo. This is where we determine whether or not the demo has been effective. Whether it's conveyed... No! What are you doing? You can't make that decision yet. You haven't played the demo. We've put so much work into this demonstration. Wouldn't it be a shame if you rushed right into making a purchasing decision without savoring it first? Let this one simmer. You'll have plenty of time to decide later.
Okay.
You missed the wall room?
The wall room.
Oh, we did too. On the right?
The right.
The wall technology.
Thank you, guys.
Now, I think you'll find this exciting. We've actually developed a wall that you can walk through. Go ahead. Give it a shot.
Oh, fuck yeah. I love that. Ooh. No clip my... Ow.
Guess it's still in development. Right. Okay, moving along.
Damn it.
Motherfucker. I was really excited for that.
Mm-hmm. How's the anticipation? Still feeling it?
Fuck you, Stephen Fry.
Yeah. Stephen Fry's a jerk.
Art.
And there you have it. Everything you need to know about how video game demos are made.
Well, oh, I didn't decide whether
did
I like...
Did you miss something? Don't worry. I'm sure we'll see it soon in the demo. However, it's still important that we address safety concerns. Please closely observe the following possible negative side effects of playing the Stanley Parable. Mm-hmm. If you agree to be held 100% responsible for any and all injury or long-term damage, mental, physical, or otherwise, that may occur while playing the demo, please do not press the large red glowing disagree button at this time. Nothing? No objections? You're quite sure about that? Well, all right then. In the event that you do experience one or all of the previously listed symptoms, let's establish a signal for you to convey to me that you wish the demonstration to be terminated. Please step into the dance perimeter. Please perform a dance.
I'm not
Your
feeling
dance
up.
Has been recorded.
Damn
in
it.
The event that you feel confused or disoriented,
it feels like I'm
anything
Kinect.
You see inside the demo,
just a little bit.
Perform that dance, and I will terminate the demo immediately. Right. All preparations have been made. It is time at last. Are you prepared for the Stanley Parable?
It hasn't started yet. Just another.
Oh, wait, what are we doing
Welcome
here?
Welcome to Stanley Parable Demonstration. Your number is 29. When your number is displayed, please enter the demonstration room. Thank you, and have a pleasant demonstration.
Okay, I'm lost. Let's just get back to the green room and start the demo again. I must have done something wrong the first time.
Is he going to go through?
Okay, here we go. The Stanley Parable demo take two. Finding the demo, learning exactly what the Stanley Parable is. Here it comes.
Hey, it worked. The Stanley Parable.
Oh, wait, what's this?
Eight. Eight.
Wait. This is wrong.
Eight.
This isn't the Stanley Parable.
Eight.
This is a game where you press a button and it says eight. Not only is the Stanley Parable not a game about continuously pressing the number eight, I can guarantee that this button does not appear anywhere in the main game. Why is it here instead of the demo for the Stanley Parable?
I love
Where did the demo go? There was an actual demo here before. Something has gone wrong. It's all gone horribly wrong.
It's okay.
We need to get you out of here before you start forming impressions of the Stanley Parable based on whatever the hell this eight game is. We need to get up. We need to start over. You mustn't stay here another minute. Out.
I like this game.
Eight.
Now, I think perhaps you've misunderstood me, so let me reiterate as clearly as I can. This is not the Stanley Parable. What you are doing is pushing a button over and over that does nothing but speak the word eight. Has that gotten through?
Eight.
You may be continuing to press this button under the impression you're playing the Stanley Parable right now. An assumption that is, I should remind you again, entirely erroneous.
Someone in the chat said I played this for an embarrassingly long time.
It's really satisfying. The amount of, you know what? I'm going to make it its own episode. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Video Games Awesome Live. We're playing Pressing 8 is Awesome.
8.
And it is.
8.
Doesn't even make sense. Why would I have gone to all of this elaborate setup just to demonstrate a game that doesn't do a single thing except repeat the word 8? The waiting room, the green room, the tour of the facility, all of that for no reason other than to contextualize and build up this particular game. Why? What about this game deserves any of that time and attention? Are you seeing something in it that I'm not?
I love it.
8.
He did it again.
8.
It's got a real nice tactical feedback to it. Actually, it doesn't at all. It's not even rumbling. But
8.
Okay. Here's the deal. It isn't possible that you still think this is the Stanley Parable. I've restated the fact too many times, which means that you are now consciously choosing to delay the actual demo as long as possible. Is that it? Are you afraid of the Stanley Parable? I suppose another possibility is that you can't hear me because you're playing with the sound off. In which case, what are you even getting out of this egg game in the first place?
The eight.
The scenario is perhaps even more concerning.
8.
Why is 6 scared of 7?
Because 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
8.
Totally.
8.
You really are finding
this horrible story,
aren't
though.
You? The experience of pushing a button and it says 8.
It's not nice.
Is this intrinsically captivating to you on its own as a legitimate experience? I mean, I'm starting to wrap my head around the idea, but it's not all the way there. How do you get into this demo? Are you our target market for the game? Should I be concerned for the Stanley Parable sales numbers right now?
Eight.
No.
Eight.
The funny thing is, you haven't even played the Stanley Parable yet. How can you be sure that this is a better game? Is this simply more compelling than you imagine the Stanley Parable to be? Have you formed such a rich vision of the game already? What exactly did I do that gave you such a miserable, awful impression of what it's like to play the Stanley Parable? Was it the dance?
just
yes.
the...
Yes. It was almost certainly the dance. I regret that now.
It's just I wasn't expecting this to be so good.
Yeah. Pick a number between 7 and 9.
8.
4 plus 4. 1 plus 7.
8.
Well, the good part is that if this is your metric for quality in a game, when we do get to the Stanley Parable, you'll be thrilled, shocked, blown away. Every one of your faculties will be enraptured by the experience of a game that does anything more than say 8 over and over. Yes, I can't wait for your entire world to be shattered and rebuilt. Magical moment we'll all share together.
You're hyping it up too much. Sounds overrated.
8. 8.
I'm happy with this.
This will never disappoint me.
8.
Well, I'm not going to pretend I don't know what's going 8. On here. You're so utterly compelled by this game that you don't intend to stop playing it until you pass out from physical
8.
Exhaustion. Well, tell you what.
8.
I'll just be right here
8.
And wait for you to finish. I'm sure 8. The Stanley Parable demo will still be out there somewhere when you're all done.
Thank you.
In the meantime,
shut up.
I'm going to stop acknowledging you. And
thank
just
you.
Let you get it out of your system. Please, enjoy thank the 8 game. Take as much time as you need.
Thank you.
Finally.
8. 8.
Hmm.
8. 8. 8.
Yeah.
8. 8. Mm,
that 8's starting to look pretty hot.
Mm-hmm.
8.
Those curves.
8.
Pear-shaped 8.
Bod. I think it's presenting.
8. 8. 8. 8. 8.
Everything's relative, and yeah, I'm finding that 8 to be very
8.
Sexy.
Mm. 8. 8. 8.
I like the one on the very right, though.
8.
That's your favorite one?
8.
Yeah.
8. 8.
I think I like the one beside it.
8.
Do you guys know?
I want the red 8.
8.
Do you guys know if this
8.
If he ever talks again?
8.
Can you outweigh
8.
Him?
8.
Can you out-8 him?
8. 8. 8. Eight.
Shoot, I don't know when this segment started. They wanted
eight.
It to be 8 minutes.
8.
We will 8 with you to find out.
8. 8. 8.
Uh-oh.
8.
Yeah?
8.
I never found him to say anything past this.
And...
8.
Yeah! What a sweet game! Thanks for watching, everybody. This has been Pressing 8 is Awesome. See you next time. All right, let's play the Stanley Parable
eight.
Demo now. God, I'm going to miss that thing. I
wait,
hope there's
wait,
a
yeah.
sequel soon.
Can you change your mind and go back?
Done. Well, in that case, what do you say we get back to business and start this demo over from the top?
Motherfucker. I'm going back to play 8.
God damn it.
I changed my mind.
Oh, it's too late.
It's 2-8. Where do I have to go now? Can I...
The first room? Uh-oh.
Somebody was in here.
Yeah.
Get ready for jump scares. Oh. Maybe not.
Welcome to the Stanley Parable demonstration.
First time.
Your number is 30. When your number is displayed, please enter the demonstration room. Thank
familiar.
You, and have a pleasant demonstration.
Pleasant demonstration.
Can I go home now?
Okay, now let's take a minute to get something straight here. When you sit down to play this demo, you are assuming an amount of responsibility for its outcome. Now, I can't say for certain whether you caused us to encounter the 8 game rather than the Stanley Parable, but I think it's a pretty safe assumption that you had something to do with it. At this time, please take a minute to think about all of the mistakes you've made in playing this demonstration as well as your lack of respect for demo taking in general.
It's cut off. Yes.
It's just cut off at the end.
Wonderful. I could really feel the introspection on my end. Now that we're all on the same page again, I feel ready to attempt the demonstration once more. In this third attempt, we shall truly come to understand the meaning of the Stanley Parable. Let the demonstration begin.
Oh. Hey. What happened in here?
It's dark.
No, it can't be over yet. You didn't see anything. Everything that was supposed to demonstrate why the Stanley Parable is a quality experience
worth
your time and money. It was here somewhere, I'm sure of it. Oh, no. We have to get out of here. We have to find something for you to do, anything. The demo cannot end like this. Hurry, this way. Okay, yes. This is new. This is different. Surely there must be a game somewhere in here. Okay. Oh, how about this cup? Yes, go pick up the cup. All right, now put it, in the bin.
Oh. Which bin? I don't know what you Brits consider a bin to be. Is that the trash?
That one.
Oh, that bin. Ooh. Oh.
You did it! You won! You know what you get for winning? An achievement.
Oh! Wow.
The Stanley Parable just keeps getting
video
better
game.
And better. In fact, let me take a little survey of your experience. Based on what you've played so far, would you purchase the Stanley Parable?
Is the 8 game included? I don't get what...
You responded...
What a clear and straightforward demonstration of the merits of the Stanley Parable. I am convinced of the quality of the full game.
Incredible. You really do get it. You understand. Oh, I was so worried. I just wanted you to know what I see in the Stanley Parable. What I think makes it, well, special. It's so very difficult to put into words. Oh, we're all beyond that now, aren't we? Come along. Let's get to the end and the final choice.
Remember the 8 game?
8.
Yeah.
That was a good time.
8.
Ending, where are you? Where are
There's
you?
There's the disagree button. Can I press it now? Oh, that would have been funny.
Is this it? Yes, the end. Now, this is where we want the demo to be over. I think it's time for you to log your final decision as to whether or not the Stanley Parable is any good. And it all comes to this. Please consider very carefully before answering. Much is at stake.
Yeah, it's not as good as 8. It's... I just don't know. I mean, is 8 included? Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's the thing. The narrator led me to believe that 8 wouldn't be a part of the final experience. Yeah, I'm not completely satisfied unless you
working?
Can guarantee me.
Are you sure? Sure you pressed the button? What? No, we finished the demo. Did it start again? Hello? Is anyone there? They already finished. They said they liked it. I need someone to stop the demo. Hello? We need to go back. We need to get out of here.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
What's going on? Where is everyone? Okay, over to the left. Down this way.
Oh, all right. Fine, anything's better than that.
Oh.
Phew.
Nice and quiet.
I've got a fern.
Well, I suppose we can both agree that I failed, haven't I?
Mm-hmm.
My job was to be a teacher, and I so badly wanted to teach you exactly what the Stanley Parable is supposed to be, but somehow I couldn't. At any rate, I don't know if I care for the Stanley Parable anymore. Do you think any of this is actually in the main game? Honestly, I doubt it. What would that even look like? No, I think I've had enough of it. No more doors, no more demonstrations, no more endings. That's the other problem with this game. There's too many bloody endings. I'm sick of them. How can one game end so many times? It doesn't make sense. Oh, but back at the beginning of the demonstration, now, that was lovely. No concerns about where it was all going. No confusion. Just a blank slate. Yes, that's what I want. A game of beginnings. Hey, do you remember just a few minutes ago when we met for the first time and I showed you the technology used to make the demo because I thought there actually was a demo? Oh, we were so naive back then. How little we knew of the world. And then when we ended up back in the waiting room, even though you'd already done that before, yes, it's all so fresh in my memory. They were such wonderful moments. Oh, and then when we played the game with the cup and won. And then we kept wandering and we ended up in a stairwell somewhere and we just kept climbing and climbing, flight after flight after flight. I thought they would never end. And then we were on some kind of catwalk. I didn't have any idea what was down there.
Oh my God.
And we just kept going and we found that elevator and it said escape on it. We talked about it for a while. About how we couldn't possibly know whether this was really an escape, but it seemed worth a try. At the very least, it would be an adventure. So we got inside and we rode the elevator up and up and up. We had some sense that the end was coming, but we couldn't possibly know when. And then after so long, it finally stopped and we stepped out into the lush outdoors, the trees, the wildlife, the sun rising on a new and glorious path.
They're not going to show us that.
The freedom. We were free. There was nothing to think, nothing to know. Simply us being right there in that moment. Wasn't it so beautiful? Wasn't that moment so singularly, piercingly beautiful? We were free.
Oh, for fuck's sakes. It's one hell of a demo.
Pretty good.
So I have a feeling that gives us, despite the confusion, an incredibly accurate depiction of what the game is going to be like. That has to go down in the history of great demos for sure.
Yeah, man.
All right, so the Stanley Parable demo, when we come back, we're actually going to play the game itself, see what it's all about, still have no idea. See you in a little bit.